Good morning, everyone. It is another Monday and it is absolutely beautiful outside. It was sprinkling on my way to drop the kids off at the CDC, but the sun is out now and it's so pretty. And I'm inside because I need to clean my house. I'm not even gonna walk around with my camera because that's how bad my house is. I have neglected my house the past few days. We've been really busy. I haven't even picked up my camera over the past several days just because of how busy we've been. But to sum it up, Saturday was my friend's daughter's Harry Potter themed birthday party, The Chosen One, and it was so much fun. I wish I would have vlogged us getting ready, but like I said, we were just so busy. We were in a rush. It took a while to put our outfits together. John made himself a new robe or whatever you call it for Voldemort at the last minute. So yeah, but I will drop the pictures that we took right here because they're pretty awesome. Yesterday was Mother's Day, so happy belated Mother's Day to all you mamas out there. My Mother's Day was very chill and relaxed, and I am perfectly okay with that because with the week I've had, I needed a day just to decompress. Dawn and the kids took me to brunch. It was amazing, very good. The kids got to pick out a flower for me, so they got me a rose. It was just really sweet. We came home and I took a nap, and it was just really nice to just relax and lay around, even though my house was a complete disaster and I knew that it needed to be cleaned. That's what I'm doing today, though. I have a few hours before the library opens, so I'm gonna stop by there and pick up a movie and maybe get a couple books because I am throwing myself into doing research for my new business that I'm starting. As I mentioned, in one of my last vlogs, I'm starting a party decor slash vinyl business, basically just making things for events, parties, photo shoots, like making photo props, making custom invitations, custom birthday cards, custom whatever cards. It's just a lot of fun and I really love it. But first things first, I have to get everything legal. And that can take 6 months or more, like I probably said, but I'm willing to be patient and wait it out because that just gives me time to nail down all the specifics and figure everything out before I actually launch my business. But I'm going to get to work on my house. As you can see, there's blankets and kids' clothes right here beside me that either need to be washed or hung up. I'm not even sure at this point. I'm just gonna be working all day on my house. My goal is to get my living room done, my dining room done, my kitchen done, and then if I get all of that stuff finished, I'm gonna start working on my office upstairs because it'll kind of make me feel more official with starting this business, just to have a clean and organized office space so I can go ahead and get to getting the supplies I need and all of that stuff. Because I found out I can go ahead and start making stuff for people, but it has to be for donation only. I can't like set a price. If they want to give me a donation for what I do for them, then I can accept that, but I can't set a price. But I'm okay with that because that means getting my portfolio together. I've collaborated with a local photographer and she's amazing. Basically, whatever props I make for her, in exchange, I get the images of the props and the setup and everything. So I'm really excited about that because that means I start building up my portfolio, people start seeing it, I get my name out there. Perfect. So we just got home from picking the kids up from the CDC. I did not get as much done as I had hoped before I left. I did organize everything into piles, and now I have to put everything up and then clean, which is like sweeping, dusting, mopping, all that good stuff. I went to one of the other posts because I had to go to the library and pick up Chamber of Secrets. I requested it like a couple weeks ago and it just got here last week, but the library was closed on Friday so I couldn't get it. But anyways, we watched the first one because we were trying to get the kids to watch it before the party so they could kind of get an idea of their characters. So we watched The Sorcerer's Stone. They didn't have Chamber of Secrets. I requested it, but they did have Prisoner of Azkaban. So we kind of watched them out of order. So we watched the first one, the third one. Now we're watching the second one. And the second one is when Dobby makes his first appearance. So Kimber will finally get to see the character that she was. When I first got on the post, John called me and asked what I was doing, and turns out he was at the commissary, which is on that post. So I met him at the commissary. We got a few things, grabbed some lunch, obviously to go. We didn't get to eat together, but it was nice to see him. I don't really get to see my husband during the day or talk to him during the day, during the work week. So it was nice to actually get to see him. I also picked up a new notebook. Mine is running out of room. I'm running out of pages because I've been taking notes like crazy trying to do research on starting a business and everything. I did try to call the home-based business guy. I don't really know his official title. I do know it, but I don't have it readily available for me to tell you guys his official title. But he was out of the office, and then I called again this afternoon like they told me to and left a voicemail. He didn't answer. So hopefully I'll hear from him soon and get all of this started. It's nice to have something to look forward to, especially something that is a passion of mine, and it's really exciting to have a goal in my sights that I'm working towards, and it kind of like gives me a sense of purpose. Like, I know I have a lot of purpose. I'm a wife, I'm a mom, I try to keep up with the house, but it just kind of helps me out.
I want to keep up with the house, even you know. Even Peggy Buffy had. And now a Peggy, I want Peggy.
Show them your tattoos. Show everyone your tattoos.
Okay.
That's the tattoos they got. Kimber, I mean, Audric was Draco, so of course that matched him. But Kimber decided to be a bad Dobby, and she got two tattoos. She peeled off this paper and like stuck them on her before we could stop her. So, whatever, right?
Let's.
All right, let's go take a nap.
Let's not, because we got company to talk.